Greetings, my friends, and welcome again to Channel 48. In the previous video, you saw Android 10 for the Samsung Galaxy Note 3. And now I'm here with a ROM that was released 2 days ago on the 17th of February, today's the 19th, for the Samsung Galaxy S4 and the Great Family. I'm talking about the i9505 models and family, okay? So this is a bunch of phones, so you must go to the one and only developers group that is supporting such a big group of these phones, and that is nobody else than the JDC team. Thank you. That was for JDC team, because they released V3 Lineage OS, well, I must say it right, optimized Lineage OS 17 for the Samsung Galaxy S4. So, I also got a comment yesterday on, I think, the last video that I showed about this ROM, saying that games are slow to play and things like that. You know, then I told them, well, we don't play games on our S4. You know, we play games on our computer, our game computers. So, yeah, if you're gonna upgrade this phone to Android 10 to play games like PUBG and all these things, I'm not doing these kinds of things, you know. I'm listening to the radio, or I'm letting the thing play TV, live TV for me, or live ATC radio. I do many things with or navigation, or name it. There are so many other things that you can do than playing games. But I can understand that if you have some kid that you gonna give your old S4 to, and you know, they gonna play games on it, then you can better be on the stock ROM. Just stay on that ROM. Don't even bother to upgrade. Because, you know, upgrading this phone from Jelly Bean that it was left on behind, or maybe Kit Kat, to 7.1 to 8, 9, or even 10, these are, you know, amazing steps. And of course, I think somewhere here and there in performance, things will, you know, not be the same as when, you know, your computer will run faster on Windows XP than on Windows 10 with the specifications that you have now these days, right? So that's the way you must as well see it. This is, in fact, a jam session. You know, the guys are jamming, they are making their music, and effect, yeah, what they are doing is presenting on us ROMs all the time for us to upgrade our phones to have the latest security patches, for instance, from February 2020. For this phone, a thing like that, hey, yo guys, let's be honest, this thing is cracked. I bought it for how much, 10 euros or so? I mean, like, nobody wants an S4 anymore, right? So probably this video will not get massive views, but the S4 lovers that still have the phone and that know what they can do with the phone, these guys, these are grateful users. So a thumbs up to all you out there that are still using the S4 on daily basis, because you can. You can go to the store, buy, get yourself a brand new battery, and the thing will be a brand new second hand for the coming years. Thanks to, you know, great development that we have coming from XDA, GitHub, guys that develop ROMs for you and me to use on our older phones. So, even though these are older phones, and even these phones are running Android versions that your phone probably will never ever get, you know, if you're having some Huawei or maybe some other old phone, you know, you can forget about it. These phones, only thing you can do with them is take a hammer and start hitting them, because you hate them so much that you cannot upgrade them, because they have locked bootloaders. And when you send a message, for instance, to Huawei, Nihoma, please, can you give me boot unlock code, that they're gonna say, Nihao, yes, I'm fine, but sorry, we don't give out codes anymore. So if you're gonna buy a phone, or you still have a phone like that, then you can forget about it. So it's very challenging that we can do these things thanks to Samsung being so, yeah, so nice. In fact, not so egoistic. Maybe they are in some way, but as well not. You know, to the developers, they are not. They are, well, not for all phones releasing all the sources that they change in the AOSP to make, you know, certain things work. For instance, with Marvel, we have a problem. Marvel, yeah, is the development is stagnated because, you know, the chip maker won't tell the AOSP, the developers, what sources they exactly modified in the OSP Android, you know, so they can as well, you know, use these modified sources to make the processor work and hardware work, you know, on higher builds of Android. So the guy came on till Android 6 and then he start mailing the guys and begging them and calling them, and these guys, they don't answer. They are like, get out of here, you little fly. Who do you think you are to even talk to us? You know, this attitude. So, yeah, that's why I decided to contact the CEO personally. And you know, I already said that in 2 videos, so I'm not going to talk about it anymore. But with JDC, you know, JDC team decided to support this phone for even 1 more year. So probably this phone will get Android 11. Just think. And probably, you know, if we are nice to GDC team, the all we S4, you know, users and, you know, owners, then maybe, you know, Dimitri will say, hey, you know what, we're gonna do it for 1 more year, because it's very challenging to them. You know how many people are as well, yeah, a little bit jealous on these guys, you know. Jealous because they are coming with things that affect, yeah, the others are not coming with. They don't put so much time into, you know, really supporting and upgrading and even making their version official. You understand? So if you have some, you know, dinero, when you go to the XDA, look at the PayPal thing where you can contribute or whatever. Hit the thing, you know, send them some, you know, and say hello from Puck. All right, so V3 arrived. I'm still on V2. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go into recovery real fast. Already copied the ROM to the phone, and then we're gonna install it. Simple thing. And then we're gonna take a look at what it is and if it's good. But knowing these guys, this ROM is amazing. So if you're looking for a phone to play games, probably be on the stock ROM and play your games from there. Don't even bother upgrading to Android 10. Okay guys, this is the site that you will see when you follow the link, and then you can read here what it's saying. Based on official LinuxOS 17.1, Android 10, R18, latest security updates integrated, improved speed, stability, RAM usage and battery drain. So maybe your game players will, maybe thanks to this update, even have more fun playing your games. Okay, so which phones are supported? Well, that's what I'm gonna show you right now, because I might not put the complete list in the YouTube description. The i95, the i95G, the i95-07, i95-08, the SCH. Is that an I or a 15? 1545, or it is i545, and SCH970, the R970, the R970C, the R970X, the SCH R970X, the i337. Hey, I like that. de i337M, de i337Z, de M919. Oké. Voor de SGH i337. ANT user, since your bootloader is locked, you must be on UCUAMDB or I don't know what that is. Okay, my bootloader was not locked. All right, so these are the models. As you can see, I did not even call all of them. The China model is supported. The SPH I720T, the SPH L720, the SM975L, and the S970G. The others we already called. And then you will see that these guys are sharing this via the Google Drive. Yeah, so this is, yeah, you need a Google account to download this, all right? But there will be no banners and a reasonable download speed, as we know from Google. You can go for the GTC twerp recovery, yeah? But there is as well an official twerp recovery on twerp.me, so it depends on you what you want to use. There's another twerp recovery, low-key patched. I'm not using this at all, guys. I'm on the official twerp, and that one works as well. Some people love Aroma add-on. Here you can get that. You see that? Gaps as well. You can get from Open Gaps or Bit Gaps. I'm not using this at all. Here you can see the twerp. See? You can either use... They say the same thing. Yeah. Or the latest unified official twerp recovery to flash. You see, this one will bring you to twerp.me. Aroma add-on, not using that. Installation guides is very simple. I'm just gonna do a clean install. Complete guide to dirty install over your custom collection. So yeah, there are several ways. So I want you to go and check out this website, okay, by the lead developer, the boss, Mr. Site, and I think that's Dimitri, or maybe I'm confused. And we have Buff 99, and somebody said that Buff must go and join Lineage OS official. And then I said, are you from Lineage OS official? And then he did not answer me anymore, so maybe that person can still, you know, answer to us and let us know why he want Buff to go to official Lineage OS. I think these guys, they are already with Lineage OS. They are creating Lineage OS ROMs. And they're doing a good job. What's not working? Root and YouTube. Okay, YouTube, you can easily, if you're not gonna, how you say that? If you're not gonna... if you're not gonna install gaps, yeah, if you're gonna use it just like me, my YouTube works, okay? Because I'm using Parafron YouTube, and we can test it, because I have it somewhere. So you can see that my YouTube works. You see that? This is YouTube, the Parafron YouTube app. So maybe you guys must push that into the ROM, guys. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna go ahead and put this phone in a recovery mode, restart, and we can restart into recovery. And this is the 9505. In the next video, I as well gonna bring yeah, the latest Android 9 ROM to the 9515, okay? This is the 9515, and in fact, I'm gonna bring you the latest ROM from Lineage OS DE, Germany, and that is by my friend called Exodus, Exodus Nick. So more of that in my next video. So Exodus, your video will as well come. Because it's been a while that I showed a video about the 9515. because that phone was not so fortunate to get Android 10. Alrighty, so I just did a wipe, and now I'm gonna install optimized Lineage OS version number 3. And there we go, Lineage OS 17.1, but then optimized, released on the 17th of February. You see that? At 9, that was at 9:30. 9:30 in the evening. So in fact, it's 1.5 days ago. Where is your warranty, dude? My warranty is gone long time ago. I don't have warranty anymore. So if you have a support problem, you should call Samsung and tell them, yes, I have a problem with my Samsung Galaxy S4. It's a problem with Android 10. I don't understand the problem. And then the guy's gonna say, are you saying Samsung Galaxy S4 on Android 10? That is not possible. We don't have S4 on Android 10. Yes, sir, I have it here in my hand. Official Samsung Galaxy S4 i9505. And it's saying version Android 10. We could do that trick. Hey, we're gonna do that soon. We're gonna make phone calls to Samsung. And then, look at that boot animation. Optimized Lineage OS. And then we're gonna tell them, yes, I have a problem with my phone. You know, and then we're gonna call a specific Android 10 function that, yeah, we're not sure how it works. And then they're gonna be like, but that function should not be available in the S4. What version of Android? Can you please go to the settings and tell us about the version? Oh, look at that. Did you see that? It went whoop. No setup screen immediately to the Nice, JDC. Amazing. Look at that. So, a minimalistic ROM. In this ROM, you won't find no browser yet, because you have browser choice. So I'm gonna install Firefox, and so I will have a browser, so I can go on the internet and get F-Droid, and so from there, you know, install all the apps that I need. There you go, the app is installed, and now we have a browser as well. Yeah, for you, the possibility to go and make it exactly the way you wish. Yeah, you can set the display size. This thing has a high resolution. This phone. There's a high resolution. So I put the display size just a little bit bigger, so my eyes can see everything just a little bit better. You see that nice dark mode? Lovely. Amazing. Let's make a phone call. Oh, so smooth, these keys. You hear that? Dun, 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 dun. Photo works. Video. Oh, look at how nice this thing films, man. Beautiful. Let's look at the video.
Beautiful.
Nice. So, wow. This is just a great phone, guys. You can say whatever you wish. Whoever's gonna call this phone not good, you are idiot. Hello? Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. If you say this phone is not good, I don't wanna talk to you. This is an amazing phone, even in 2020. Whoever is ungrateful when you give them this phone, you should give them a slap in their face and tell them that you will never ever give them anything again, ever. I tell you. This is a nice phone, man. Look at that. Wow. Beautiful. Hey, but what I find a little bit of pity, why is the phone not black? I would love to see the phone black as well, you know? Just like in the previous run that I showed. Or was that something that I did? I can't even remember. I'm gonna look again. I'm gonna check that again. Let me put a nice widget here. A nice clock. I also found out how to get nice clocks. Nicer than the official ones here, this one. I just love this room. It looks beautiful. It looks amazing on this phone. Look at these nice little black buttons. Wi-Fi. Can go ahead and connect. Lovely, man. Wow. This phone is so lucky. So here you can see it. Look at the logo. Lovely, lovely logo. Deaf connection. I'm gonna make a distro, and I'm gonna call it JTC OS, and I'm gonna put their logos inside. It's for them. I'm gonna do it on Ubuntu. I made one for Lineage OS. I made one for Resurrection. I think GDC is the next one to get their own Linux distribution put together by me. Out of thanks for what they did until now for my old cracked Samsung S4 i9505 and the models that you saw on the website. Well, longer I don't have to make the video, right? Because, yeah, you already saw it. V3 updated. Now I'm gonna go ahead and install my applications and, you know, just set up my phone. If you were on the first version before this one, you could do a dirty flash and then, you know, all your applications would still be there. What's a dirty flash? A flash without wiping. Just go into the recovery mode and then select the file and install it on top of the other. And all your files, all your settings, even your Wi-Fi, you know, everything will still be there. Only the Android will be updated. I want to thank JDC team again. Of course, Side and Buff, you know, big up, great work. All the others that helped as well, you know, thumbs up. You are all champions out there. Keep up the good work. And thank you so much for this ROM released 2 days ago. And it was a big honor for me to show this again to you here on YouTube, probably as the first video showing the V3. Once again, thank you for watching. Tune in to my next video. Subscribe at all time so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new video again. And of course, if you love this information, leave this video a thumbs up. And then I say goodbye.